Hi guys, Joff from Professional Music Technology here. I'm here with Jamie from Alesis today, and we're going to be looking at the updates on the new Alesis Strike Pro. So, Jamie, tell us all about this new update that you've just brought out.
Right, I'd be happy to. Thanks, Joff. What we've got here is the Strike Pro kit. Now, I know you like this kit. You're very familiar with it, but for the friends at home, let's just go over what we've got here first, then I'll talk about the actual update benefits. We have got the amazing Strike Pro. You've got real-world drum sizes here. You've got a 14-inch snare drum, 14 inches, just like a regular drum, 14, 12, 10, and 8 tom-toms, all dual-zone, snare drums dual-zone. 14-inch mesh bass drum, all the drums are mesh actually. Triple zone 16-inch ride cymbal, really feels great to play. Three zones, crashable, chokeable, nice and big. Three 14-inch dual zone crash cymbals we've got as well. A moving hi-hat, 12-inch moving hi-hat, goes on your favorite hi-hat stand. So this is a real big, substantial, great drum kit. Feels just like a real kit to play. But we've got a new software update, and this brings so much more added content and value to the kit. Firstly, we've got 15 new drum kits, 15 brand new sets. This is all a free download, by the way. So for existing Strike owners, it's your lucky day. And for new Strike owners, people are just considering buying one, the kit is even better. So 15 new kits. Improved trigger response, so the triggers all respond beautifully. They were great before, but there's always things you can do to improve it, so it responds really nicely now. We've got unlimited recording time. Previously, you could only record 50 seconds of audio, 53 I think it was. Now, it's unlimited according to how much space you've got on the memory card, and we supply an 8 GB memory card. That means you can record more than 10 hours of audio onto this machine, which is incredible, 10 hours of stereo audio. I've got an improved graphic interface, so the screen looks a bit nicer when you navigate around. Also, we've got near instant drum kit loading times. These kits, they take dozens, hundreds of WAVs, go into each drum kit. It's fully WAV playback, this system. But it's now instant. When you go from one kit to another, virtually instant. Some kits are straight away, other kits are within 2 or 3 seconds maximum. So it's almost instant kit loading time. So there you go. Yeah, it's an amazing update. And there's a real emphasis on realism with the new kits as well. They are super realistic. So a bit later on in the video, you'll get to hear that. But we're very excited.
Excellent. Yeah, I was really impressed. As soon as we did the update on there, I noticed a drastic change in how the whole kit responded.
Yeah, definitely.
Before, I was absolutely happy with it, especially with the sizes of drums, things being in real size, what I'm normally used to playing on my own acoustic kit.
You can rock out on this one, can't you?
Absolutely, yeah. I felt really comfortable with it. So, especially as you were saying, the screen display, you know, everything is you know, a real sparkle that's been put on it as well.
So I think
it's looking really good.
Excellent. Yeah, we're very excited about it. And the new kits are really realistic. When you listen to a recording of them made, it just sounds incredible.
Jamie, that's fantastic. Thank you for that. I mean, that's kind of a brief overview of what the new update is. Let's have a listen to some of the new sounds that are on the kit.
Certainly. Okay, well, once you do the update, the new kits are at the beginning, so there are now 131 preset drum kits after it's been updated, so that's incredible. Let's have a look at number 4, one of the new ones. It's called Birch Slap. Lovely, super realistic Birch toms. All these are real sounds, real samples. They sound realistic because they are real sounds. Trigger responses. Hi-hat is lovely and responsive. There you go. Forgive the playing, but that gives you an idea. So that's number 4, Birch Slap. If we go forwards, Natural Maple, number 7. I think this was an incredible kit. It sounds so clean and pure. So this is ideal if you want to make a recording yourself and add your own sound treatments onto. Really clean. And of course, when you use the Strike Pro, you've got 8 individual audio outputs in addition to the 2 stereo ones. So you could take all of those individual elements of the kit, feed them into your PA for your gig, feed them into your mixing desk for your recording, and then control them that way. But if you need to use a kit for a pro application, you're going to need to be able to do that. You need to have the individual audio stem. So we have 8 audio outputs here. Check out the sound of this. Beautiful. Now, I quite like the new jazz ones as well. Check this out. If we go to Bebop Jazz, another one of the new kits here, number 14, this one. Really low-pitched, crashable ride cymbal. You can really dig in. Because it's got 3 zones, bow, bell, and edge. Lovely. So that's number 14, Bebop Jazz. That's another new one. And if you want a bit of fun, if playing a regular drum set is just becoming a bit too boring for you, then try this one out. There you go. So nice. So there's loads of new kits on here, but the focus I think is on realism. So this is a really realistic set of drums. You've still got dozens and dozens of electronic kits on there as well, loads to choose from. But with the new content that's been added, there's a real sense of accurate, real drum sounds, I think.
And with those new sounds as well, I mean, where are these all done? They're all new recorded, completely recorded drum sounds.
They are. Yes, indeed. Alesis have taken on a brand new sound team. So we have our own in-house sound design team based in America, and they record drums. They're drummers themselves, actually. And so they're making world-class drum content, and it's going to be available exclusively to Alesis. It's going to come on the new kits, not just the Strike, but some of the new ones as well. And this update that you get for the Strike, like the previous updates, is completely free of charge. So we're supporting you. You buy a product from us like this, we will support you and give you as much free content as we can.
Wow, that all sounds great. I mean, you mentioned a minute ago, you mentioned increased sampling time. So, I mean, the interface, I had a go on it before, and, you know, just from my phone, I managed to just download some stuff onto there and create my little loops and samples, but you now say that it's an unlimited record time on there.
Absolutely, that's right. So if we now hit record, the kit ships with an 8 GB SD card. You can put bigger ones in if you want to, but with the included 8 GB one now, if we hit record here, you'll see that we've got 10 hours and 51 minutes of stereo recording time available. So that's basically the capacity of the card. I'll show you how that works. So if we just pop this in here, we can find, so that's an auxiliary audio input, so you can record real audio into the machine. I'll find some audio for you. Let's play this track. There we go, we can hear it there. So, I'm going to go back to the beginning of that track now. What I'm going to do is record some audio, chop it up and loop it and show you how easy it is. So first thing we do is press record. Now press play. Make sure we get enough so we can loop it. That'll do. Stop that. And there we have it on our screen. There's the waveform. So we can now quickly edit it. Really easy. Look, a drummer can be a producer. Move over, Kanye West. This is how easy it is, look. So we can do that and go to the end. I think we need to stop just there. So you zoom right in on the waveform, because when you're making a loop, you need to trim it so that it marries up to a nice bar pattern. Switch loop on, press play. How's it gonna sound? Perfect, there we go. Now what we do is we save that, so we save it. We have the option to save it as an instrument or a loop. If we save it as an instrument, we can then assign it to a pad. And once you've got that saved and assigned, you can put it through the onboard effects. You can filter it. You can assign it to a pad. You can chop up multiple loops. You can make your own drum sounds. If you're at a rehearsal, the keyboard player's got some drum sounds. He can just connect his mixer to this. And then you can quickly record those sounds in real audio. You record your own drums. And of course, while we're on that subject, if you use the free software editor, that is another free download from the Alesis website, connect your computer up to this, you've got full access to the architecture of how all the patches are put together. So you can make custom instruments with dozens and dozens of WAVs at different volume levels to make a really expressive instrument. For example, a snare drum on here might have 80 WAVs, literally, and you can make your own version of that by recording your own drum kit and make your own custom instrument, easily load it onto here, and have a truly unique electronic drum set.
Yeah, that was my main thing when you showed me that before, was that just being able to access every velocity,
right.
Rather than being one sample, louder or quieter, or blending it with something else, so you could actually have every sample at all the different velocities on there.
That's right, yeah, exactly. So you can record audio into here really quickly and easily, make your loops, but if you want real expressive power, use the free software, the Strike Editor software, and you can make your own custom VST instruments that way.
It's brilliant, because I know I've done for recordings, you know, after you finish the recording, they'll go through each individual drum at various velocities in case there's a missed note you need to fly something in. So yeah. I know myself, I've got a hard drive with different snares and things like that, that I could completely have my own snare on that
exactly,
recording.
That's right. It's your amazing. Own kit. No one else will have that. That's just yours.
Excellent. So how does this, you then assign this to a pad on this one?
Yeah, you go to voice menu. So we've now saved it. So we can, it's called New Loop 1. We saved an instrument. We'll hit save. There we go. And then once you've done that, you go to voice and then note chase. Select a zone. Put note chaser on so it doesn't move away from that zone. And then we go down here. Go up to there, and then go to instrument, select our new instrument from the user list, because when you record an instrument, it goes onto the memory card as a user instrument. Select it there. There we go. A bit loud. Turn the sample down. It normalizes it. So then you go back to the voice menu, and you can take the level down a little bit, switch the loop mode on, take the level down because it's a bit loud, and then it should become a loop. And once it's a loop, you can start and stop it. You can also put it through the onboard tone, which has got nice regular tone and a filter, for example. So we can filter it. You want to make it a bit thinner. There we go. So that's a high pass filter. You could put it through the onboard kit effects. You've got reverb, parametric EQ, onboard compression, and two further configurable effect sends. So it's you can do all of this from your drum stool.
Wow.
It's remarkable.
All sounds brilliant on that one. How do we get this update on there for the module?
Sure, it's a free update from the Alesis website, alesis.com. Follow the links to the actual product page, or just search Strike 1.4 update. This is 1.4. It's available for PC or Mac. You download a disk image for your Mac. You just simply download it and then open it and run through. One process will update the actual software, and then you restart the module. It's all, the instructions are all contained. It's all from one file. It's very, very straightforward. Then once you've restarted the module after the software update, you then put the content on. It takes a few minutes because there's so many new WAV files and drum kits, so have a cup of tea. It takes about 10 minutes. Same thing for Windows. Instead of a disk image, it's actually a .exe file, so you open that, it installs a program on your computer, nothing to worry about, and you can take it off again afterwards. But the same thing applies. So you need to use a USB-B cable, that's the square printer cable, square at one end and regular at the other. And that's it. So it's a very simple process. Anybody who uses a computer can do it, PC or Mac. About 800 megabytes is the size, or bring it into your friends at PMT.
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, for any of the ones that we've done around here at PMT Portsmouth, do feel free to drop them in and we'll happily do them for you. Or if you're anywhere else in the UK, do feel free to go and pester Nathan in Romford. He'll happily do it for you as well. But any of the PMT stores will always be happy to help on these. Jamie, thank you. That's been absolutely brilliant. Thanks so much for that. For any more information on the kit, do have a look on our website, which is pmtonline.co.uk. Don't forget to follow us on Facebook and Instagram, which is PMT House of Rock or PMT House of Drums. And also, if you give this video a like and share and subscribe, that'd be fantastic. Hope to see you guys again soon. Thanks very much. Bye.